Okay, we're going to change the entire body of the light bulb. At this point, we just pull out the fixture straight out of the ceiling and then unplug the disc off the back of the light bulb. And you can see that we're going to replace this part right here, because inside these holes
they're starting to get pitted out and they're not any good anymore. The light bulbs go away, the pins on the bulb will go bad.
And so this is fiberglass and the wire has fiberglass coating, so I've got a sacrificial pair of scissors here that I'm just going to go ahead and cut right through the whole thing. Now
make sure your light switch is turned off.
Okay, at this point just take scissors and slice up the fiberglass outside tubing, and that will let you have access to the two sections of the wire that are fiberglass coated. I will just cut off the extra piece of sleeve.
So we've got our new light body, GU-10. I'm going with GU-10 style, two porcelain wire nuts, because this is a high heat environment.
And, you want to take your wire strippers and go with your smallest hole size that you can afford to go with. Strip back some sheathing. Try not to lose any of your wire in the process. I've got mine on the second to the last hole in this particular lamp. And it's a little dark in here for me to tell you what number that is, but it looks like 18 gauge. So, and then we just pull off our little silicone sleeves on this silicone high heat wire. And these are ceramic bodied sockets capable of running 50 watt light bulbs. That's the whole goal. Now, there's no left or right. They're all the same, so it doesn't really matter which wire goes on which. In this case, they're all white. Make sure you're lined up good though, so that they get a good bite into the wire nut. So at this point, I like to sort of fold it over and stick the old wire up in the hole a little bit.
Let's see.
Okay, put our new light bulb in there, turn it. I like to hold onto the ceramic body of the light because the glue between here and the bulb, sometimes that's not all that good, and you can actually twist that glass part out of the socket. So you want to be careful about that.
At this point, if you have the glass lens that goes in here, which this one does not,
you should clean it. It's a good opportunity to clean it if it needs cleaned. Fold up in there before you put it in so that it's up and out of the way, and then it just pops back in.
That should give you a fresh light. You'll be using GU-10s now. Sorry about that, had to test it out.